Final topic of the day, my Malkin's moments. I said to preview the show this morning that this is one of the best Malkin's moments that I've had. I've had a lot of great shows, but these Malkin's moments right here are truly some of my favorites. So we start in the NFL. Tom Brady became the first quarterback to throw 600 passing touchdowns in his career. He just continues to amaze and break new records, shatter the mold, just set the tone and just defy physics with his age and his production. It's been unbelievable. And the Bucs right now have the second best record. They're tied for the second best record in the NFC, 6-1 they improved to. They absolutely annihilated the Chicago Bears, 38-3. And of course, we all remember how infamously Tom Brady was, that the infamous moment Tom Brady unfortunately had to deal with against the Bears for getting the downs last year, which cost them the game. And yet they're 6-1 this year, and he leads the NFL most passing yards for a quarterback. He's been absolutely sensational. And again, it happened with 10 seconds left in the first quarter. He hit Mike Evans, and Mike Evans Mike Evans always gives his touchdown balls to the fans. He just gives it to a different fan, and he kind of innocuously gave this 600th touchdown pass of Tom Brady to a fan. The Bucs officials had to come back and retrieve it. I don't think that Mike Evans didn't realize quite how special this touchdown pass was. And Brady said, well, yeah, I kind of would have liked to have had that. But then on top of that, the moment that Brady had with this young fan was truly touching and heartwarming. There was a young man, a young child, that had a sign that said, Tom Brady helped me beat cancer, beat brain cancer specifically. And Tom Brady came over to him at the end of the game. He gave him his Bucks hat. He shook his hand. And you saw the child break down in tears, almost just overjoyed by that gesture. And it just further elucidates how important, how impactful athletes are, not only to the youth specifically, but to fans and to communities, how far their reach can go and how much of an impact they have on people. Just, it almost brings a tear to your eye seeing that reaction. I would highly encourage people to check out that clip if they haven't. It was truly a touching moment. And I'm just appreciative, again, that we get to see a lot of these elite athletes kind of give back and want to be a part of these moments for families and kids that will stay with them for the rest of their lives. That moment is going to stick with that child and that family for the rest of their lives, but especially that child for the rest of his life. It was truly, truly an amazing, amazing, heartwarming moment. And again, to see the child break down in tears, can't imagine what he's gone through, for him to be there and to experience that moment, have that brief conversation where it's just Brady and him, is just truly, truly special. And not to mention, Sunday marked actually the 37th time in Tom Brady's career when he's thrown at least 4 touchdowns in a game, and the 97th time that he's thrown at least 3 touchdowns in a game in his career, both tying Drew Brees for most such games in the NFL. In the NBA, Carmelo Anthony passed Moses Malone for 9th on the NBA's all-time scoring list. Even at 19 years of age, he now jumps Moses Malone to move into 9th place. He has scored now 27,423 career NBA points. Had a fantastic showing last night. It's not like he just barely kind of sluggishly reached that mark. He went out guns blazing, 28 points in the game, led the Lakers in scoring, 18 points in the second half, which is where it occurred, 12 points in the fourth quarter. He was efficient, 10 of 15 from the floor, 6 of 8 from the three-point line. He had a plus 19 on the court, had 2 blocks as well. So Carmelo Anthony, it's amazing that he was kind of this reclamation project in Portland. and he was given an opportunity to resurrect his career. And he's not only taken that, but he's run with it, and he continues to be a productive player. He's averaging 18 points per game for the Lakers for the first three games. So he's actually a really valuable contributor and has transformed himself, revamped himself into an elite shooter once again from the perimeter, which was something that we didn't know he had in his arsenal. And it's not surprising. He's been one of the best scorers in NBA history ever throughout his career, whether he was in Denver, whether he was with the Knicks, his stint in Portland, and now with the Lakers. It's just tremendous, and it's an honor to watch him play. It's still crazy to envision him as a Laker, watching him in the Sunday whites is still kind of I'm still taken aback at times. So big shout out to Carmelo Anthony. That is a fantastic, fantastic achievement. And final two Malkin's moments, Matthew Stafford completed his 300th career touchdown pass. Think about what I just said. Juxtapose Tom Brady, who just threw for his 600th touchdown pass. I'm still giving a compliment to Matthew Stafford throwing his 300th touchdown pass. He completed a two-yard touchdown pass to Cooper Kupp, and he became the 13th quarterback in NFL history to throw at least 300 touchdown passes, and he was the fourth youngest to reach that milestone behind Peyton Manning, Dan Marino, and Brett Favre. In fact, Stafford also tied John Elway for the 12th most touchdown passes in NFL history. Big shout out to him. And then finally, the Atlanta Braves. Huge congratulations to the Atlanta Braves on reaching their first World Series since 1999. It's their sixth World Series appearance all time. They've won three World Series before. What's amazing is the three times that they won the World Series, they actually originated in different cities. So 1917, they were the Boston Braves when they won the World Series. 1957, they were the Milwaukee Braves when they won that World Series. And in 1995, which was the last time they won the World Series, they were the Atlanta Braves. And so as a member of the Atlanta Braves, 1995 is the only time that they won the World Series. The last time they reached the World Series was 1999. So they're the only MLB franchise to have won a World Series from three different cities, and now they get an opportunity to win in 2021. They're taking on the Houston Astros, and for them, obviously, the fact that they got to redeem themselves against the Dodgers, defeating them 4-2, the fact that they blew a 3-1 lead to this Dodgers team last year, and to come back the following year without Ronald Acuna, and still get here, still advance to this spot, is a testament to their entire team, to the leaders that they have. And listen, overall, they're a hard team not to appreciate and not to root for. Obviously, I rooted against them because I was a Dodgers fan, but from a character person perspective, there aren't guys that you can't really appreciate on that team. Freddie Freeman just seems like a really good guy. I don't know him. He just seems like a good guy. Ozzie Albies seems like someone who really cares about baseball. Rosario is a guy that jumped around from multiple teams. Austin Reeves, 24 years old, just kind of emerging. So this team's got, you know, Max Fried's been there for a while. They have some guys that have been there a while. So I just kind of am happy for them. Obviously, selfishly, wish the Dodgers were playing in the World Series. But you have to give credit to the Braves. They were fantastic, especially the last 20 games of the regular season, carried that all the way through the postseason. So big shout out to them. I hope that they will defeat the Astros. I'll probably talk about the World Series on Wednesday. The first game is tomorrow night in Houston against the Astros. So that's all the time that I got for today. Thank you so much for joining me right here on Morning Joe every single Monday and Wednesday morning, 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 10 to 11 Central, and 8 to 9 a.m. Pacific. Make sure to subscribe to my YouTube page, Morning Joe with Jonah Malkin on YouTube. You can follow me on Twitter at @morning_Joe or just @Jonah Malkin on Twitter, jmalk97 on Instagram, Jonah Malkin on TikTok and all those. Make sure to subscribe, review, comment. Always love and appreciate the comments and the likes. So that'll do it for us. Thank you so much once again. And as always, have a lovely rest of your morning.